Everybody, welcome to another clip. I'm back in the Barrington Tops. Now today I've come for a day drive. Once again, Kaz has to work, which is sad, but that's just how it is. So it's a day trip. Now, I'm starting at the usual place that I always start my Barrington Tops trips, which is at Cobark Lookout. And normally it'd be a great view, but as you can see, today it just isn't. So it's foggy, it's a bit cool, considering it's summer, and only a few days ago we had 40 degree temperatures. It's certainly not that today. Anyway, just come out for a day trip, just look around the forest again. I haven't been up here for a few years, so probably go to the usual locations and see the things we can see, and hopefully you enjoy the clip. Come with me, and we'll go and find out what we can look at. Cheers. Only a kilometre maybe from the lookout, come to a little information kiosk. So we'll go in there and we'll have a look. It's been a little while since I've checked it out, so we'll go and have a look at that and read up on what's going on in the park. So we've made it up to the information centre, or the information board. It's not really a centre, is it? So I'll give you a look at that and find out what there is to see in the Barrington Tops National Park. Now, I know I've done videos up here before, guys, but I thought I'd come and have a bit of a recap and see what we can find out about this. We're at Cobark Park, part of the Gondwana Rainforests of Australia Heritage, and gateway to the subalpine plateau of Barrington Tops. So, it's got acknowledgement to the traditional owners and stuff like that on the board here. So this, I don't think it's a lot to tell you about this park, but from where I'm parked, it seems to be just a little walk in to the park with a couple of picnic tables. So, nothing too much to go on there. You can drive into this bit. Where I'm parked is for buses, coaches, cars, but you can drive a car in here. Now, obviously, on a day like this, it's a bit foggy, rainy and muddy. So it's probably not a particularly great day to come here for a look. But look, you can. It's a walking trail that goes up here. Now this I've not seen before, so go for a quick look up here. I've been to that sign and we've not noticed this before, so why not have a look? A little straightforward walking track. Now most of this rain is not really rain, it's just water falling off the trees from the very heavy fog that we've got here at the present time. So you walk up this little path and get you to another little shelter, which looks like it would have at one stage had the info board on it too, but there's nothing on there now other than graffiti. So yeah, she's all done and dusted. So I think I'll just continue wandering down to the other parts of the national park and the forest and see what we can see down there. I haven't got a lot to tell you about this. As I said, this is just a recap trip. It's only a day drive. I would come up here to camp, but it's midweek. I've got things I need to be doing. So I'll be going home again today. Yeah, that's that little Cobark Park. And we'll go on to see what else the Barringtons has got to offer. I hope you guys can see me all right. Different camera angle today. Turns out my over the windscreen camera that you probably see up here in the corner decided it wants to be flat, so I've got to use this camera. That's okay. Just thought I'd mention that on weather conditions like this where it's foggy and it's a bit damp, I've elected to put the vehicle in four-wheel drive. It's in four-wheel drive high range. Also, I didn't show you at the start of a trip airing down, because you've seen everybody airing down God knows how many times, so I didn't bother showing you that, but I did air down. I'm running around about 24 pound. The range is fairly light, so 24 seems to be a pretty decent pressure. And these roads that we're on, it's all two-wheel drive stuff, but it is bumpy. That dirt forest roads. This one we're on now, Dilbury Circuit, it's a slightly lesser one than the main road we're on. So it's a little bit bumpier. Now, as I said, all this main forest roads area is doable in road cars. But what my point is I've put the Ranger in four high, because this is the Rangers in particular are primarily a rear-wheel drive. So unless you put them in four-wheel drive, you don't get anything from the front. And as you've got the ability to have front doing something to help you, then why not use it? Particularly when the roads are wet and the conditions are a little bit average. So give that some thought, guys. And I'll spin this camera around actually and show you what I'm dealing with here. Like, it's not hard, it's just the way the weather is at the present. Let's tilt you back. There you go. That's what I'm looking at. Not a great deal of visibility and a damp dirt forest road. Now it's not hard. You see the bumps like that, you've got to be aware of them, or you possibly do yourself some damage on the suspension or the tires. But yeah, just got to drive to the conditions, guys. Anyway, I just thought I'd give you that little tip. So Well, I can't show you much more because it's bloody foggy. But anyway, we'll show you what we can at the next point of interest. Alrighty, I've pulled up in a campground. Now, I've camped here before and I can't think of a name of it. I'll put it up down the bottom, guys. I'm not going to go for a walkthrough of it. I'll put the link up here as to the campground that when I did a spotlight on it. I'll give you a quick look after the rainy conditions we've had. So it's still a beautiful little spot. The truck's running because it's a bit cold, guys, and I've got the heater on slightly. But you've got this gorgeous little river. So if you're in the area and you want to camp, this is a fully bush camp. It's just a great little spot. This river goes round the corner. Now, those who've been watching for a long time would recognise this one. I've camped here twice. I believe I videoed it on both occasions. I was here with Brett, the den monkey. I was also here with Mark. So I've camped here a couple of times. It's a good little spot. I just can't believe I've had a mental blank as to the actual name of the camp area. Anyway, there you go. It happens. So just walking past the car and give you another little look at the river down here. Beautiful little spot, but bear in mind, it's got nothing as in the way of amenities or anything else. But it's just a cool little place. It's off the Dillery circuit. So come have a look at it. So that said, I move on and look at some other famous attractions. So we'll see up there. Now where I'm parked on the Dillery circuit, if you're driving along, you could miss this, but somebody has nicely written on the tree here in spray paint, The Rock. Now, if you've ever been up to Barrington, you've probably heard of this rock. It's very famous for its shape. So I'm going to go for a quick walk up there, even though you've seen it before, and show it to you again. Well, we've arrived at the rock. For new viewers who may not have gone back through my videos, here it is. The rock. It resembles an interesting shape, don't you think? And that's why people come here, just to see this particular rock. So, we'll now venture back to the car. And of course, on a wet sort of day like this, all the vines and things that grow over the track make it a little bit unpleasant. But it is what it is, eh? All right, I'll get back to the car and show you what else there is to offer around the Barrington Tops. Turned down Gummy Road off Dillery Circuit Road and Hemi Road and I've come down to what's called the Gummy Picnic Area. I honestly can't remember if I've been here. You can hear the water in the background. I'll go for a look at that in a second. Now, obviously, on a day like today, probably not that exciting a place, because you couldn't use this table because it's too bloody wet. I'll go down the road and that'll be a little bit better, I think. Probably should have gone back into the car park, but anyway, we'll go this way. And I'll show you down the bottom in just a sec. So just down the hill from where I'm parked is a little road bridge which is going across this river. So I'll give you a look at this. A bit muddy on this bridge, but anyway. That's what you can see downstream, that's pretty nice. Yeah, this bridge is quite muddy. Trying to keep me footing. And there's a view upstream. So not bad at all. So come down for a look around this Gummy Picnic Area. Have a look at that nice river. Now I think there's a way down to it. Looks like there would be, so we'll go for a quick wander down here. This is on the Gummy Road, which is a turn off the Dilgree Circuit. I probably mentioned that already, but anyhow, I've mentioned it again. On a wet, slippery day, I don't plan to come down too far down here. It's not bad, this river, eh? I'm not walking too far where I could go arse up, and I'm not staying in one spot too long, because no doubt there's plenty of leeches around. I'm not a fan. Just really don't like getting bitten by leeches. I doubt whether anybody does really. It's just not something I like to have happen. I head back up to the car and we'll see where else we can go on our little Barrington moist day trip. Well, after I left that Gummy Picnic Area, I continued along Gummy Road and we ended up running into a bit of a track that I wasn't prepared to drive today. So I turned around, came back out, and I wound up on the Thunderbolts Trail, which is the road I was on originally. But I for life can't remember where this goes. So I thought it would lead back to the main sort of road in Barrington, but anyway, I have a feeling it will, but geez, a long way around. Anyhow, it's all part of the fun. Hasn't been a lot to show you other than this kind of forest road, but because it's a bit wet, today is a day I'm glad I'm in a four-wheel drive and not in a road car. But, hey, I'm not going to enjoy the cleanup. Thank you. I can tell you guys, I've turned this into a bit of an adventure. I don't know how I wound up on the wrong track, but I did. And in the end, I've got, I can't keep going that way. So I've turned around, I'm going back out the way I came in. But, of course, with the way the weather has been, these roads have turned a bit mushy. So I'm glad I'm in a four-wheel drive, because in a road car, this would be a problem. Yeah, I haven't filmed everything, but I've had some slippery patches. I've had, well, this is a main road. I've had all sorts of wheel spin. I nearly slid off the track at one stage. So I've been concentrating a bit and haven't been filming. So I hope you can understand that. And then you get onto bits like this, which are perfectly fine. But I've been on two wheel tracks. It looks like mostly shrub. Truck tire tracks where they've been logging, and that's just turned to mush. So I've obviously missed a turn somewhere. But my GPS says I'm on the Thunderbolts Trail. So I know that's the way I came in. So I've literally gone the other way, and I'll just find the turn off. Either that or I'll wind up back at Dilgary Circuit again. But yeah, it's kind of funny, guys. There's not a lot I can show you from outside. Still dirt tracks, but sometimes don't do what Steve does. Well, I'm feeling a bit better about myself now. I've come back off Thunderbolt's Trail. And where I came on to Dilgary Circuit, or came off Dilgary Circuit earlier, I would have turned right to go back to the rock and where I'd been. So I've turned left because Dilgary Circuit should get me to where I'm going. Right, well, it's a bit bloody windy, a bit cold, but behind me is Pole Blue. And we're at the Pole Blue picnic area. Over in the distance through that path that you may or may not see on this camera, is the Pole Blue campground. But this is the picnic area. So we did finally get here to have a bit of a look at it. After our slight adventures. So you've probably seen the picnic area and campground before. In fact, I'm sure you have. If you haven't, I'll put a link up here somewhere. So up there. Oh God, I'm a shocker. Anyway, so it's bloody 1 o'clock. I haven't had anything to eat yet. So I'm just gonna have a look to see if I'm out of the wind if I come in here to the barbecue area. It's also still a bit wet. In here in the barbecue area, it is quite pleasant. I believe the barbecues work, but I'm not interested in those today. So it's nice in here, it's out of the wind. So I might grab me stuff to make sandwiches and bring that up in here. And I might still put a jumper on. But you guys probably don't really need to see me making sandwiches and things, so I'll bail out, do that, and after lunch I'll come back and we'll continue on our way. I forgot to show you the general state of this car. Get a load of it. She's a bit grotty. Gonna need some serious cleaning. But, as we said before, it's all part of the
fun of exploring and off-roading a bit. All right, I'm going to get this jumper on and have some food. Well, we're just heading in to what is considered by some to be one of the creepiest areas in Barrington. I quite like it, but some people find it creepy. It's the Firs. Now, you've definitely seen this on previous clips, but how can I not show you again? So I'll get out and give you a squiz at it all. All right, guys, as promised, coming into the Firs, which is Stewart's Brook State Forest. Still part of Barrington Tops, but anyway. I'll take you for a look in here. Now, you can't camp here, but there's picnic tables and a fire pit. But this part apparently creeps people out. I'm not sure why. It is always very silent and still in here. I've never been anywhere it's windy. Now, it's windy in other parts of the Barrington Tops. Just doesn't seem to be windy here. So it's, I don't find it creepy at all. Check these out. Go for heaps too. They're not very deep from the car park until you get out through the other side. I've been here before, stupidly today, along with everything else I've forgotten. I forgot the drone. So I can't bring any drone footage here, which I would have liked to have done, so sorry. You literally just pop out the other side here and you're back to normal Australian bush. Now, these were obviously planted at some stage, but I can't remember the details, but they go a considerable distance down that way and a considerable distance up that way. But yeah, you're back in the bush, but yeah, Australian bush, relatively light. These things, dark and scary. And it would appear they go further than what I first thought. But anyway, I'll check out that other bit in a minute.
far from coming out of the Barrington Tops now, and it's taken till 2:30 with the fog to finally lift. But anyway, I know it's not the usual style video I do, but I hope you enjoyed it anyway. A little bit surprised that the gate's open, but I got a feeling that's because there's a lot of trucks going in and out at the moment. Usually that gate's shut. Anyhow, I'm going to run down the mountain and I'll air up when I get down the bottom. I'll end the video there, guys, but probably not a lot to show you down here. Oh, there is some nice views, so I'll keep this camera rolling for a little bit so you have a bit of a look at the scenery. Alright guys, you can hear the truck idling in the background, just finished airing up. Hope you enjoyed this clip, as I said, a little bit different. Anyway, if you did enjoy it, put a like on it, really helps the channel. If you're new here, consider subscribing. If you do subscribe, click the notification bell, you'll know when a new clip comes up. To the old hands, as always, thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch one of my clips. Keep in touch with us on Facebook and Instagram. Not as active there as I should be, but keep in touch anyway. If you'd like to support the channel, consider joining on YouTube and the join button underneath. For a very small sum, you get early releases of the clips. But you don't have to. Or if you'd like some merch at the moment, still only got patches and stickers, but t-shirts are coming. Go to the website, mudduckstouringaustralia.com. Have a look there, look at our history, and see what you think. Anyway, thanks again for watching, guys. All the best. Cheers from Steve and Kaz at Mud Ducks Touring Australia. We'll see you on the next one. Cheers, guys.